Hey guys, I'm Ruby Rose and you're watching Getmusic. Guilty pleasure came about in, it was a hard, tough job. Basically a whole lot of musicians and songwriters and producers got flown to Bali and we got to stay in these amazing villas surrounded by wildlife and monkeys and just the beautiful sun, and we got to record music every day with different people. So it was kind of like it was like drawing numbers out of the lottery, and every morning they'd choose a top liner, an artist, and then a producer. And you know, I wrote some great songs with artists like, or you know, artists and songwriters like Brian Lee, who did Good Time with Kylie Rae Jepsen and a lot of Lady Gaga's stuff. I wrote a killer tune with a guy called Anthor, who's also really well known. And when I walked into the studio with Gary Goh and Stuart Gritchen, it was just like, I never thought I'd be that person that says, so we walked into a studio, it took us about half an hour, we recorded it, and then we were done. Like, after interviewing artists for the last 6 years of my life, you know, you hear those stories and you're like, oh yeah, whatever. And then to have been part of that, where we walked in and the melody we'd already, oh sorry, the beats had been laid down, so the melody we kind of made together, we separated either side of the pool, I wrote my verse, Gary wrote his, walked in, sung it, and just kind of went, do you want to go sunbag? It was incredible, it was really good. Calvin Harris. I mean, he's on fire at the moment, and now I regret it because he was one of the first people I interviewed. We had such great rapport, and he's such a funny bastard, and I loved him. And then I actually opened for him a couple of times, and now I'm just like, God damn it, I should have really schmoozed more. Like, I was too busy just like being excited, you know, DJing with him and watching him, but I should have just been like, let's be best friends. Because I knew he was talented, but what he's doing now, like, he's on fire. He just, wow, it's out of control. I don't know anyone else that I want to have remixed to that level. I mean, the Swedish House Mafia boys are grouse, but Calvin's just gone nuts. I'll take you home in every style. Second favorite thing at the moment, you know, is boxing. And it sounds mental, and my manager's like, why? And my mum's like, you know, I had my first official amateur boxing fight recently, and I won, and my mum didn't breathe for that 9 minutes. You know, it's 3 2-minute rounds, and she just like was purple in the face, just so freaked out. And I don't like worrying my mother. Manager, she can deal with it. But it's also something that's in my blood, just the discipline and the art. And it's not brawling, you know, there's a real delicate romantic kind of movement to it. And the key thing to boxing is music. It's footwork and it's timing, and it is like dancing. And also it's all like, when I'm training, I'm listening to music, I'm thinking about music. And it kind of, if you think about it like eating food and then you have like something to kind of cleanse your palate, that's what boxing is. So I'll hit the studio and I'll get all kind of, you know, confused, and I'll be like, too many songs going on or too many things in my mind, I need a break. And then I'll go and do some boxing for 2-3 hours, and then I'm ready to go again. So they go really well hand in hand until I have a nose like that. I mean, I don't know. Run with Wild Horses. I love that one, but it's got a couple of years on it now. I mean, I love all of them. I've kind of always loved this arm. If you look down at my wrist, it's all those little tattoos. So there's like a love heart, a smiley face, a star, peace sign, life, rainbow, an analum, which is like a Buddhist kind of thing. I've got them done in different countries. Like, they weren't all done at once. So, and then the cross was in Bali, and trust in God was when I went sober. So this is called my happy hand. So it's also my best punch in boxing, ironically. And then Dankeschön I got for my fans when I sort of hit like a certain amount of followers on Twitter and a certain pinnacle in my career. And I just thought, you know, I don't know, this whole arm and my childhood of Astro Boy, Ninja Turtles, Pizza Cat. But I did just get one last night and no one's seen it yet, so I'll show you. But Lionel Rose was my godfather, so I got that for him. And I just added the Thorn, which is my boxing name, to the top. So that's a bit of a favourite too, because like I said, this is the hand you got to watch out for if you're ever boxing me.